Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, children. So in the previous class, we have completed the two paras of the first lesson, right? So let's continue with the next page. So on globe, you will see a line at the center which go right around it, right? So on the globe, you can see here. A small line can be seen through it, right? Which separates the two half of the earth, right? Two half of the globe also we can call it as. The line, what is called this line? This is called equator, right? Which divides the earth into two half. That is northern half, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, right? So as a sphere is round, shapes like a ball and a hemisphere is half of spheres. So the northern hemisphere's most point of the earth are North Pole, and the southernmost point is known as South Pole. So the northmost point is known as North Pole, and the southmost point is known as South Pole, right? So it is a globe. So there are, in a globe, there will be a line which separates the two half of the globe, which the line is called as equator. So the northernmost point is called North Pole and the southernmost point is called South Pole. Okay, so let's come down for the next para. The globe also helps us to understand how the earth spins on its own axis, right? So how the day and night came, you know, because the earth rotates its own axis, it does not have any device to rotate the earth, right? So it rotate on its own axis or spin on its own axis. Okay, so in that way we get the night and day. Okay, so when night fall, the darken come, it is considered as a night. When we get the sun and day, when the rays of the sun falls on the other side of the earth, which continue as a day. If it doesn't fall on that side, it continues as a night. Okay, so you will see the thin rod going along through the globe from the North Pole to the South Pole, right? So thin rod like this. See this one. This is the rod which connects the two poles, that is North Pole and South Pole. Okay, so you can spin or rotate the globe around this rod. So it is made for the spinning purpose only. With the help of this, you can rotate the globe any way. Okay, so in the same way, the earth spin on an imaginary line called its axis. So it doesn't have any line, we cannot see, like we are in a reality, we have been seeing the earth. So only the space centers and the books are written on the written books we have learned, right? So it is move on its own axis. An imaginary line called it as axis is tilted just like a rod in the globe. So it is just tilted like a globe, like a rod in a globe. Okay, so I hope you all understood, right? So let's go with the activity part. So take a Mosambi, that is straight line. Ask your teacher to cut it into four quarters as shown in this picture, right? So place the four peels together in the same, okay? So then this is how Earth's surface will look on a sheet of a paper. But maps are never drawn in this way. So sometimes the Earth also shown a flat surface as shown below, right? It's an important point we can call it. So let's come down to ocean. What do you mean by ocean? Can anyone tell me what is ocean? The water part? No. Can anyone tell me what do you mean by oceans? The blue colored portion shows in the large bodies of water called ocean, right? So you'll see the most of the globe is colored in a blue part. See here, it is colored in a blue part. Most of the part is in blue color, which indicates the water bodies, right? So the blue color portion, that the large bodies of water, is known as ocean. water covers most of the